Upload a list of keywords and get full blog posts almost instantly. And best of all, it's SEO optimized and it bypasses AI detection. Let me show you what I'm talking about right now. Content at Scale is a content creation machine. It uses AI, NLP, and it also crawls Google to bring you relevant content that will combine that to give you SEO optimized word blogs. Now, the best part about it is that it practically does it automatically. Now, let's get started with this. Now, this is one of the ones I already made a test on, and it wrote 2,509 words automatically by giving it a title and a few keywords. Now, before I get into this one, which is in Spanish because I'm actually using this, I'm gonna go into the projects and I'm gonna show you how to create a brand new one. Now, to get started, you're gonna go into new project, and I would suggest this for every single site that you're going to use. So it's different categories and different niches. In this case, I can give it a project name. So that would be the company name or the website name. And I'll say it's Mast Fast. This is what I'm gonna write. It's one of my sites, which I'm going to start working on. And I'm gonna give it a project context. Now, it strongly recommends this because all the information that we're going to add, the target audience, the project context, the language, the tone of voice, it's all going to be a combination to give you that content that's gonna write automatically. So let's go ahead and write something that's relevant. So what is this site about? I'm gonna say modern construction materials for homes. Okay, that's going to be the main context. And who is going to be the target audience? I'm gonna say this is gonna be for architects. So let me go ahead and write that down. Okay, so the target audience for this specific site is, this site is meant for architects and contractors who want to build homes. Now, the better you write this, the better content you're gonna receive. Okay, the language that we're going to use, in this case, it's English, but you have all these available options. And the site, a monthly post, in this case, I'll leave it as one just for testing, but this will depend how many posts you want to write a month. Exactly, for example, one a day, one every other day, etc. Just add the monthly post that you want to generate, and that will depend on the plan that you have for the available posts that you have a month. The tone of voice, it will depend what you want to use here. I want to use, for this case, informative, but you have different types like joking, masculine, persuasive, professional, etc. And it's just gonna depend how you wanna write that content automatically for the type of site that you want. So in this case, it's informative. And then we have the word count. 2,000 to 3,000 words is more than enough. I mean, that's a lot of words, but that's good. If you need less, you can go ahead and select these. I'll go ahead and create the project. There we go. And then it's asking for what keywords do I want to rank for? Word counts, okay. Additional context optional. It's optional, but I would recommend that you use this. So let me give it some context here. Okay, now we have the context for this, which is building modern homes is all about using materials that are strong, lightweight for better construction, okay? And you can go ahead and create content with this, or we can go ahead and go into customize. Now with customize, I like it because it's going to generate content briefs, which is pretty cool because it's gonna be based on what I wrote right now, and I can select what I wanted to write content as of right now. So for example, I can use steel framing, insulated concrete forms, I like that one. Insulated panels and solar panels, well, that doesn't go with this. You can go ahead and edit this. For example, you can see what it's about and you can decide if it's something that you want to use or not. You can go ahead and edit this, okay? So in this case, we're good to go with these two. I'll go ahead and create content now. There we go. It should start writing our content now. So we have this, modern materials for building houses that are modern. And we have the status here. So it's still working on this, 0%. It takes a little bit. Now, another cool feature that Content at Scale has is that you can do this manually by some keywords, or you can add a CSV. So for example, I can add a file that's a CSV, and it's gonna be way easier. I can drop down a whole list of keywords that I want to rank for, and it's gonna write that content for us automatically. So it's super easy to do it this way. Now let's go back into our page right here, and let's go ahead and wait for this to finish and come back. Okay, our content is now ready. Now let's go check it out, which is this one. I'll go ahead and click on it, and this will open up the information for this piece of content. We can optimize it more if we like, or we can leave it as it is. Now in this case, it wrote 2,106 words automatically. Now this is the piece of content that it wrote. I'm going to go ahead and open this up in another page so we can actually view it. So we have our title, we have a summary, we have the table of content. Now, if I click on the table of content, it'll take me right to that section. Now, if you pass this to WordPress, it'll actually do that also. So we have the sections here, steel framing, insulated concrete forms, structural insulated panels, solar panels, frequently asked questions, and conclusion. Now, be aware that I don't have knowledge for construction, so steel framing, this is gonna write it for me. Even if I don't know about the subject, it actually did the research on its own and it wrote it for us. Now, if I hired someone to write this piece of content, 2,100 words, that's probably going to cost me around $100 to $200, depending on who I contract. So be aware that this is a steal and it's doing it automatically. Now, it also gets these little key takeaways that are in green. I like it because it's like little summaries of every section. If I go down, there's a summary for this, and I can view this piece of content. Now, if I want to edit it, yes, I can do so. Everything here is editable if I like. I got the keywords here, for example, the optimization. I have all the keywords that are ranking for. For example, this is mentioned 31 times, 6 times, 3 times, 1. If I feel that I need to rank for any of these keywords, I will add it more into the piece of content. Now you have your on-page checklist, so you can go through it, and you have your brief here. So if you want to grab something from here, from the context, for example, if I like something from the 8 most known materials used in modern architecture, I'll go ahead and select it, and we have these. For example, brick, which is super common. I can select it if I like it. You know what? That's something I do want to add into my piece of content. I'll click on this little plus button, and it's going to integrate it inside of this content just by clicking on that. And I can go through these and start adding them. You can see there's brick in modern architecture. Now we have that piece of content here, and it raised the words up to 2,361. So that's pretty cool, right? Now you also have the review if you need to request plagiarism scan to check if this doesn't match other pieces of content, which is pretty cool. Now, aside from that, we have our title, we have our URL slug, the meta description. We can even select a featured image for this. So based on the content, it's going to give me some examples of what I could use. Now I can go ahead and search for something else. For example, bricks and mortar. Something like that. Or I can use something from here. So for example, I'll use this, use as featured, and there we go. We also have the paragraphs, which is 36, and it's giving me, I should have 40 to 44, which is the example. So I should add a bit more. Headings, I have 11, it should be around 9. We also have the media, if I need to add images, which I should, because it's giving me the examples. 10 to 12 images would be a good amount for the piece of content that we have right now. Now, once you like what you have here, you've given it that extra tweak if you like, or just use it as it is, we can go ahead and copy this. We can go ahead and use the source, which is what I would recommend, because this will give you all the structure just like you're looking at right here. So like I said, it'll even give you the table of contents where if I click on it, it'll go to the next section, and you can grab that by the source. Or we can download the WordPress plugin in case you're going to use this on a WordPress. If you go to the top avatar, you can go ahead here and download it. Download WP plugin, okay? And you have several options available to edit this content. For example, create divide container, your export to Word, export to HTML. We have a spelling checker, change the font sizes, the alignment, and all that good stuff by here, okay? Now, once you start creating contents and you put this on autopilot, you have your dashboard. Let's go back into dashboard, and you're gonna see it right here, which is where you're going to see everything that's going on. Post created, words generated, time saved, cost saving. You have your filters up here, your post worked by day, post by stage, pending optimization, pending editing. You're gonna have everything right here once you start using this in autopilot. And in projects, you're gonna be able to view all your projects available here, and you can add more projects depending on the plan that you have. Now, it's super easy to use, like you saw in this video. It's easy to create a new project, add the details, add the description, the keywords, and start generating those contents really easily and on autopilot. But there you go, that is Content at Scale. If you wanna grab it, I will be leaving a link in the description. Now, if you are interested in knowing Jasper versus Content at Scale, I'm going to leave a link if you wanna check it out, Content at Scale versus Jasper, because it's a different type of content. Content at Scale is SEO based with the SEO checker, like you saw right now with the editor. On the other hand, you have Jasper, which creates AI content, and it just starts generating a lot of content, and most of the time it's really repeated, which could get detected as AI, and you don't want that because then your ranking is going to be hit by Google. But there you go. That is Content at Scale. Like I said before, check it out in the link, and that's a wrap.